In this video, I talk about my automated follow-up system, how to manage your pipeline, and how to make sure you don't get stuck in your business.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. Yeah. I don't need her. I don't need him. Fuck it, I do it myself. No one's got this. No one's got that. Fuck it, I do it myself. Everyone's scared. Everyone pussy. Fuck it, I do it myself. Everyone watch. Just keep looking. Fuck it.
What's up? It's been a hot minute. I've done a video in a while. I'm beat, man. This is Yay, who's on the TV talking about how, oh, the tariffs, the tariffs, the tariffs. Crazy. I wanted to have a chat with you guys. I haven't talked to you in a while, and I figured just taking a couple minutes to myself, relaxing a little bit, and figure we could chat for a second. How you been? Leave me a comment. Let me know. You know, I'm interested in how your May went. I need my sunglasses. I feel like it's bright. I hope I brought them in. I did bring them with me. Look at this view today, man. It's beautiful out there. It is, it's amazing. There we go. Much better. I'm beat, man. I just got up from like a 1 hour nap because we just closed one of the biggest months out that I've ever done globally. And when I say globally, I mean like out of all the businesses. Let me see if I can get you guys set up here for a second. I got this super sweet tripod that Keith Kalfas recommended to me. Oh, there we go. Sweet, sweet magic. If it doesn't fall over. So we just had a really, really big month. And it was good. May was good for us. I hope this wind doesn't affect the sound. May was really good. Easy Pro, the ad tech business, my coaching, my books. We launched the Phenomenal Phone Calls hard book this month. That was fun. We watched over 60 apartment buildings this month with Easy Pro. It was crazy. I didn't do any speaking. I did do a speaking engagement. I can share that with you guys. I did a speaking engagement at Belterra Casino, which was kind of ironic. My buddy Frank Zinniak and myself, he's been doing continuing education training for probably close to 30 years for the HVAC electrical and plumber market. And him and I are starting to slowly work together on how we can, you know, mesh our two businesses, because he's very old school. He does email marketing, but he built his business off of direct mail. He's got the social media side of it. So I'm trying to figure out how we can collaborate a little bit. And that speaking engagement was very cool, because I'll tell you, one of the biggest things that stood out to me was that I was right across the river from where I grew up. You know, when I decided to be an entrepreneur, when I decided that I wanted to do public speaking, because let me tell you guys, like, public speaking is the most fun that I have out of everything that I do. The businesses are fun. They're stressful at times. And it takes a lot of work. It's a lot of long hours. And the speaking is not an easy business model by any stretch of the imagination. Dealing with some heartburn. Ooh. But, so I did one speaking engagement that was solid. May was a good month. And I talked in a couple of the Facebook groups, especially in the Inner Circle group, about this morning, is that, you know, we're bringing on another person to the team just to handle all the leads and stuff that we have coming in, and to do the follow-up, because we've got about 1.3 million in estimates on the books and nobody's following up with them. So that's something that as a business owner I look at and I say, okay, hold up a second, we gotta fucking fix this. And that goes true to any business, right? The follow-up is where the money's made. You know, only 10% of salespeople ever follow up with a prospect four or more times. Only 10%. 10%. And I read a study one time that said that 80% of sales are made after five or more touches. So you literally have 10% of the people making 80% of the money because they follow up. The biggest problem with this is that you treat your business and your, more importantly, your sales side of your company, you treat that like a bucket. And it's not a bucket, it's a pipeline. And so that's the challenge is that you have to overcome, is that you're facing this limited capacity of mindset, because that's where it's at. It's the 6 inches between your ears. It's the biggest challenge that you'll ever face. I had a mentor tell me that a long time ago, and it's true. Because look, when you think of your business as a bucket, like you have to fill a bucket up, that means that it has capacity. Pipelines don't have a capacity, right? Like the thing flows straight through. Here's what'll happen is that if you push so much top-end volume in, or front-end volume as some people call it, you know, your pipeline maybe can't handle it. But with the ability to use technology now, you can really automate a lot of the processes that used to just have to be done, like keeping track of it on pen and paper. And so I wanted to walk you through that in this video, and kind of share that with you and what my follow-up process looks like and how I think all businesses should have a follow-up and lead collection. So at the beginning of the pipeline or at the top of the funnel, it's the same fucking thing. A funnel and a pipeline are the same thing. Funnels normally run horizontal, and you've got stages in the pipeline. Pipelines run horizontal. Funnels run vertical. And essentially, at the start of your pipeline or the top of your funnel, doesn't fucking matter. You've got to have some form of traffic. You've got to have people that are coming to see your offer. What are you offering them? And so, with that, you can use social media. I mean, I'm doing that now with a YouTube video. You can do that with Facebook. You can do that with Instagram. You can do that with email marketing. You could go to a trade show, because let's face it, why do you go to a trade show? Because the traffic is there. You can go to networking events. It all depends on what do you got more of. You got more time or you got more money? You could do cold calling. That's a great way to generate traffic and awareness to your business. A lot of big businesses are built on cold calling. I built my first business on cold calling. So what's all that mean, right? Cool, DJ, I gotta get a traffic source. You have to create brand awareness. That's the first step of the game. If nobody knows who you are, like, you're not gonna be able to close a deal. It's not gonna happen. So the idea is that you can, you know, build some type of traffic through marketing of some sort that provides you with prospects, people that might, maybe, possibly could be interested in your service. Those are what we call, 9 times out of 10, a cold lead. If somebody opts in, and it'll depend on your opt-in trigger or what they, you know, why they call, right? Hey, I saw your postcard, so I wanted to call and get a quote. It's a warm lead, maybe a hot lead. If someone is using some type of a lead generation, like you guys have probably seen this before, fill out my, you know, go here and get my 3-page report on the biggest X to avoid while trying to do Y, right? Like they give you that if-then statement that'll help you to move forward in the progress. It's good copywriting. And so when you have those different levels of opt-ins or the different levels of bait, if you will, that's going to determine how easy it is or how difficult it is for you to make the sales call. And so understanding that, you can poise your company. That's why I don't do a, like, you know, here's 3 tips to hiring a contractor. Like in my easy, in our power washing company, our exterior cleaning business, is that, you know, to me, I would rather just make a marketing video, go straight to the consumer. If they like it, they'll opt in. If they don't, fuck them. That's kind of just how it works. And then, you know, they can call in They can call in, they can send us an email, they can opt into a form, all that good shit, right? But you have to have that first step, which is just that lead collection. How are you going to get the people's information, their name, their phone number, their email address? I had a company tell me one time, I was talking to them about merger and acquisitions, and they were like a broker, like a business broker, and they said that every name, phone number, email, and my phone went dark on me, it's about to go dead. So what I was saying is the name, phone number, and email address, those are worth $10. If you can get a name, phone number, email address, that's how you can value a book of business. So if people have 100 of those, then their book of business is worth $1,000, basically. So use that and understand that. And then the more data you can collect, the more valuable the database becomes. Your database is an asset in your business. Now, the bank might not let you borrow money against it, or you might not be able to list it on a statement about when you're trying to get a line of credit. But from a business standpoint, you need to look at your book of business as a clear-cut asset that has value in your business. So we take the lead through, we've got it, boom, we move it forward, and they're interested. So now we've got some interest that's been generated, and now a salesperson or you will be reaching out to try to make this deal, okay? This is where we get into the SOSC method, and you can check that out. There's a video here on my YouTube channel. I'll link it down in the description below. I always say that shit, I never link it, so you'll probably just have to go searching for it. And so basically what you can do is now you're in that method. So here's where the magic happens. Once you send the quote, you're only going to close like maybe 3-5% of those, like cold right off the rip. You're going to have to do some type of follow-up. So I love retargeting ads on Facebook. Anybody that opts into our form, goes to our website, engages with us in some form or fashion on social media, they get hit with a bunch of retargeting ads. And then from there, that's part of my follow-up. They're going to see me when they go on social media. We're going to send them a couple of emails, automated emails, over the next 365 days, and I have a schedule of calls, text messages, and voicemails. It's plain leaving. Pretty wild. It's one of the coolest things about living up here is the sky, the view, and the airplanes. I got a little distracted by the jet. you gotta see me out here for the air show. It's like I'm like a kid running up and down my balcony. So we've got this, and we have to have some type of systematic follow-up. There has to be a system that you or your team is going to follow up. That's why we're hiring another person, is because I don't have the human capacity to maintain the follow-up system. So now I have to add more humans to increase my human capacity to operate the system. You have technology and human, both of those are resources, right? Capacity. You have so much technology capacity, maybe the number of computers you can buy, the amount of software you can afford, things like that. Listen, my business runs 10 times easier on me now because I have the money to be able to afford software. That's why, that's what Phenomenal Phone Calls was all about. That's why I wrote that fucking book, is because I know there are people starting out that can't, you feel me? They just can't spend the money. They don't have it. They physically don't have it in their fucking pockets to give to the companies to say, sure, here, ClickFunnels, here's $300 a month. Here, Zapier, here's $50 a month. Hey, here you go, the text provider that I use, I can't even fucking remember the name, here's like $100 a month. Here's SlideDial, here's another couple $100 a month. Like, by the time you look at it, you're rolling $1,000, $1,500 a month just in software to help you automate your business. That software then becomes basically like a fucking employee because it's doing a bunch of work. So I get it if you're not to that level yet, but that has to be your focus. If you want to run your business hands off, where you don't really have to do a whole lot but put out fires, that's where you have to get. You have to be able to invest in that software. And that means making enough money, making enough margin. Margin is the magic word, okay? So margin is your profit margin that's left over. Gross income, we minus operating expenses, we minus hard costs. Net income, that's what's left over. You have to grow that enough as a proportion of your top line so that you can afford these things. Because you know, if I wasn't spending $2,000, $3,000, $4,000 in advertising a month at Easy Pro right now, if I didn't have another $1,000 worth of software to run all the systems, you know, it's 5 G's a month. That's 60 grand a year. I get it. I remember when I was doing $100,000 a year, and I'm like, I can't, like, what the fuck? Why can't I make more money? And it's because I wasn't fucking spending any. Like, I was stuck with, you know, keeping all the money for me, and you know, I was reinvesting in the business, but it was going back into operations, not into sales and marketing. That's the trick, guys. That's the trick. You have to invest your money back in sales and marketing, because that's what makes the fucking phone ring. Kills me. When I lose one of these insurance clients with my ad tech company, and they're like, oh, well, I'm going to put it on hold for a couple months. Like, why? Where the fuck else are you going to go spend $600 a month and get in front of 100,000 sets of eyeballs? Like, that's it. Crazy. But hopefully that helps you. Hopefully that gives you some assistance, some clarity. I'm headed down to the P Club now. Might have some cocktails with my buddies at the club. It's been a good month, man. Been a damn good month. So what's the moral of the story? What's the goal of the video here? We talked about how to follow a sales system, follow a process, have lead generation, how to do follow-up. That's all those things are very, very important. And listen, I know I repeat a lot of this stuff. You'll see this in a lot of my videos because it's fucking important. And you have to do it in your business. That's it. That's all there is to it. If you're going to be successful, you have to do these things. Because if not, I'm down here. Because if not, I know, this is such, that's like such a douchebag shot at thumbnail. if you don't do these things, you're gonna get stuck, man. And I don't want you to get stuck. That's like, that's the most important thing to me, is for you not to get stuck. So use these tools, resources, techniques. Do whatever you gotta do, man. You gotta hustle, it's worth it. I say it all the time. Go out there and hustle. Get yours. There's so much money, there's so much abundance in the world, it's ridiculous. And if you haven't got my book yet, Phenomenal Phone Calls, go check that out, man. It's free. You just pay the shipping, phenomenalphonecalls.com. I will put a link to that in the description. You guys have a fantastic weekend. See ya.